Lanciate forbici al mio comando tutto qui sta. Lanciate forbici e rasere pettini al mio comando tutto qui sta. Ve la risorsa poi del mestiere con la donnetta col cavaliere con la donnetta la 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 l'era col cavaliere la 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 che bel vivere che bel piacere che bel piacere per un barbiere di qualità Tutti mi chiedono, tutti mi fogliono, donne e ragazzi, vecchi fanciulle, con la parrucca, presto la barba, con la sanguigna, presbiglietto, tutti mi chiedono, tutti mi vogliono, tutti mi chiedono, tutti mi vogliono, con la parrucca, presto la barba, presbiglietto, Figaro, Figaro.
Who's there? Who is it? Oh, you know it, you sing it, Robin.
Figaro!
Oh, bravissimo! Oh, signore, in the audience.
Oh, Figaro!
A great audience today, bella voce! We got a Figaro, a Figaro, a Figaro, 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 Figaro! Oh, ahimè, che furia, ahimè, che voglia! Uno alla volta, per carità, per carità, per carità! Uno alla volta, uno alla volta, uno alla volta, per carità!
Ehi, Figaro, son qua!
Ehi, Figaro!
Son qua, Figaro là, Figaro qua, Figaro là, Figaro su, Figaro giù, Figaro su, Figaro giù, prontissimo, so che mi fumere, sono i fagotti delle città, delle città, delle città, delle città, della città!
Bravo Figaro, bravo bravissimo, bravo Figaro, bravo bravissimo, ad fortuna, ad fortuna, ad fortuna, non me che la, la 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 la, ad fortuna, ad fortuna, ad fortuna, non me che la, sono i facatum della città, sono i facatum della città, della città.
Thank you. grazie. Oh, mille grazie. Oh, thank you. What? Big crowd.
Wow. That was fantastic. I've never heard you sing that before. Oh, wait. See, audiences may remember Gabe as Figaro at Casa Feliz 2 seasons ago, and as Figaro in the sequel of The Marriage of Figaro past fall.
I got married. Yes,
so Gabe has actually performed this role of Figaro in either Rossini's Barber of Seville or Mozart's Le Notti di Figaro a number of 9 times. I dare say this might be your favorite role, Gabe.
It is definitely one of my favorite roles for sure, Chev. And yeah, who's keeping track anyway? Ironically, though, that's not the role that I have performed the most. The role that I've done the most is a contemporary opera, Lieutenant Gordon in Silent Night. I was very honored, very fortunate to be part of the world premiere of that opera, which won the Pulitzer Prize back in 2012 at Minnesota Opera. And that's really what kind of launched my career, I guess you would say, in the opera industry, and put me on the radar for Tobias Picker, which would lead me to be cast for Fantastic Mr. Fox.
Yes.
A little segue there.
And that is the reason we're actually here this afternoon. The big Grammy win for your performance on the recording of Tobias Picker's Fantastic Mr. Fox. You know, I've been dying to see this Grammy, and actually, you know... Can I touch that?
Well, let's make sure everyone at home can see. I'm going to zoom it in the old-fashioned way by just moving it close. Oh, I think I almost fell off the stage there. Yeah.
We got to
stay 6 feet apart.
We're social distancing here. Right. My mask is here.
Afterwards,
I'll take a whole photo shoot with that, Gabe.
You go, Mom. It actually has my name on it. See? There you go.
I would like to also say our entire cast here is social distancing, and including our fantastic pianist, Robin Stamper.
Let's hear it for Robin. Wow,
standing ovation, Robin. You just played the socks off that largo. Thank you so much. So instead of having you sit down, Gabe, we're just going to make you sing about it.
Well, and luckily, I happen to bring some props with me, and I'm going to sing. This is Mr. Fox's aria from Fantastic Mr. Fox. Let me just see if I put on some weight during the pandemic.
Oh, yeah, that's quarantine.
That's right, the quarantine 15, as they say. Let me get my fox ears. So here is Ah, the Smell of the Night. Ah, the smell of the night. As the night begins to work a spell, as men go home, the woods begin to stir. In burrows, hollows, cavities and holes, the animals awake. This is their home. By hour, it feels so good to be alive. Quicken, whiskers quiver, ears stiffen, eyes flash and sparkle like glowing charms. Adventure, mystery, wonder fills the air. Feel them, hear them, smell them, see them, taste them. Why does it feel so good to be alive? Nature fills me with fierce excitement. I breathe in her wild scent of life. Free to wander, untamed and untamable, she fills me with vagabond joys. Life
burns in my veins, possessing my senses. It flows through my heart and my mind, alive and ecstatic, cunning and quick. The fox knows the secret of freedom. The fox knows the secret of freedom. The owls shriek. The vixens cry. The night bats squeak. The wolves howl. And a chorus of crickets to spur me on. The forest alive with a thousand eyes, glowing, gleaming, flashing, flickering, watching. Why does it feel so good to be alive? Ah, the thrill of a fox's life. What a joy to run, to dart, to fly like an arrow through forest endless deep. The wind at my face and my cubs behind me. A scent of ecstatic excitement just ahead. This is the hour, my hour. Why does it feel so good to be alive? Alive!
Well, I don't think they liked it, Chef.
Oh! You forgot to hit the applause button. Oh my goodness, they did like it. Thank you. Thank
I was
you.
So like enthralled in what you were doing, Gabe.
That's all right.
Someone commented on how foxy of an opera singer you are.
Oh, my dear. I hope so. I guess my wife is watching. Thank
I
you.
Sure, I bet she commented on that.
That.
Speaking of foxy, Gabe, can you give us a little background on Fantastic Mr. Fox?
Sure, so actually, I did not play the role of the fox. I'm going to have to take this off. So
costume change.
Costume. How about that for costume change? I actually played the role of Farmer Bean, the bad guy, and it was such a crazy experience. You know, not often do you get to audition for Mozart or for Beethoven, the actual composer of the opera, but I was able to go up to New York, sing for Tobias Picker in his home, and he asked me to audition for the role of Farmer Bean.
So in his actual home?
Yeah, in New York, exactly.
Wow.
And, or in his studio apartment. And nonetheless, so I had to learn this crazy aria. You know, it's fun music, but it's complicated music, as you just heard. I never sung it for anybody. So the first time I'm singing it is for the composer, and luckily he liked it enough that he cast me. I did it at San Antonio Opera, then with Odyssey Opera, then we recorded it with the Boston Modern Orchestra Project. And big shout out to Tobias, if he's watching. It's an amazing piece. And also to Gil Rose, who was our conductor for that recording with Boston.
Hi, Tobias and Gil.
We're waving out to Gil and to Tobias. So I think next maybe I should do Farmer Bean's
aria. We'd actually love to hear it.
And ironically, he shoots off the fox's tail, so it's appropriate. I'm holding the tail. There's another joke kit. Do you saw that? Oh, there you go. Oh, there you go. I'll just throw this back here. But
you're so spot on, Gabe.
I'm killing it. So Farmer Bean, you know, he loves his cider. So we got to have some cider here. And as a farmer, I figured I would bring some chickens.
Okay.
Does that kind of count as a... Oh,
that makes sense. Banner. Oh, that one. Oh.
And I got another one here. This one's kind of fun. It's the kind you get at the...
That's
the
my favorite
place.
One.
All right, here Definitely. Is Farmer Bean's aria. He's talking to the other farmers about how they're going to catch that evil fox.
Shut up, both of you, we have work to do. Picker means useless, we have to make money. Now what I adore is my cider store. That's what delights me, how it excites me. And what makes me smile is a lovely pile of cash that I can stash when I sell the stuff at market, yes, oh yes. Luca, moolah, bags of dough, the quarter, the pound, and the humble peso. We'll get rich and there'll be no hish to cash, to profit, to wealth. Yes, on money we're hell-bent, if it's nickels, dimes, or the humble cent. So long as there's lots of it, we don't mind a bit. To lucre, to moolah, to tote, that's all very well, but there is a hitch. Do I have to remind you about that box? That verminous, septic, pestilent, pustulent, viperous fox who steals our chickens, roosters, and geese, not to mention the cider which I adore. We have got to destroy him, and I have a plan. Such a scheming, ingenious, devious plan. It will thwart him forever, forever. Oh yes, oh yes. Shall I tell you about it? Now he always escapes us. Do you know why? He can smell us, he can smell us. With his sensitive nose, one sniff and he knows we are there. There's only one way to take him unawares, and that's when he leaves his warm tin. I have found the entrance right under the tree. We will go there tonight and we'll wait for him. As soon as he pokes his foul nose outside, we will blow him away. Just like that. And then we can get on with what we like best, making money. Yes, on money we're hell-bent. If it's nickels, dimes, or the hobbleson, so long as there's lots of it, we don't mind a bit. $2, 2 pesos, 2 yen.
They loved it, Gabe.
They loved that one.
Now, that was some fairly complex singing. And that was, you know, you spoke about how complex the score is. Now, the score seems really riveting. But tell us, though, how did you find out about your big win for this?
Well, that is an interesting story. Of course, I was invited to the Grammys, which was such an honor. I wish I could have gone. But unfortunately, I had a gig. You know, as performers, we gotta take the gig, right?
Would you have worn that tux at the Grammys?
Yes, because this is my only tux.
Okay.
I don't know if I should admit that. But yeah. So I was doing a gig at Utah Opera. Shout out to you, all of our friends, Chris Macbeth, Carol Anderson there, Utah Opera. Loved my time there. Doing Silent Night, again, doing Lieutenant Gordon. And it just so happened, the day of the Grammys, a singer in the cast got sick, unfortunately. And they didn't have time to fly someone in, so they asked other cast members if we knew the part and could sing his part while he acted it out. So not only was I singing Lieutenant Gordon that day, I was also doing the role of Father Palmer. So I was kind of focused on like making sure I was
pulling double duty. Yeah.
Pulling double duty. In the meantime, like looking at my phone backstage.
Pulling triple duty.
Exactly. To see if we had won. And sure enough we did, and the show was still going on. So I found out backstage, and I couldn't, you know, yell about it backstage. So I just had to kind of whisper to my colleagues, like, "Hey, I won." And they were so happy for me. And such a great group of guys and gals in that cast. They were super supportive of me.
Gabe, we're very, very excited for you and for your win.
Just like, it was kind of creepy. Congratulations, exactly.
So that moment that you found out, you really actually wanted to.
That's what I wanted to do, but I couldn't because I was backstage, yeah. So, you know, the whole thing was really surreal. It still is surreal and kind of like a dream.
Huh.
That's a good segue for our next
That's aria. A fantastic segue for our next song.
This next aria is one of my favorites, Un Sogno o Realtà, from Falstaff by Verdi.
Un sogno o realtà. Testo è un sogno. Basta fuori, torni, spediti su di testa, tua moglie
stare e mette in assetto non a tuo, la tua cosa e il tuo letto. L'ora è fissata. Tramato l'inganno, sei gabbato e truffato, e poi diranno che un marito geloso in insensato, già dietro a me pane con gli offischi passando urbo dallo scherno. Oh, matrimonio inferno, dona demonio, nella lor moria abbian fede i babbei. Affiderei la mia birra in tedesco, tut me tedesco olandese e l'urco. La mia bottiglia d'acqua viti antorco, no, mia moglie a se stessa. Ora in cor mi torna, e corna, voi capron, le fose torte, oh, le corna, le corna. Voi non mi sfuggire, no, sozzo, reo, dannato e piccoreo. Prima io copio, e poi li colgo, li copio, li colgo, li copio, li colgo, li copio, li colgo, li colgo, li copio! Io scoppio!
Actually, every time you sing, I feel like I'm in a dream anyway.
No, we need a sound effect for that, because that's complete BS. But that's
no, no, I'm totally in a dream every time you sing. So what have been some of your other favorite songs or arias?
You know, one of my favorite arias is actually Tanzlied from Die Totenstein. And it's not done that much, because the opera is like... It's a big piece, a little abstract, I guess you would say, but gorgeous music by Korngold. Absolutely gorgeous music. So I'd love to share that one with
everyone. We'd love to hear it.
Träumt sich zurück. mir's Haus blaut, ein inniger Blick gestand mir's ihr bittend Wort. O bleib, o geh mir nicht fort,
beautiful playing, Robin. Beautiful singing, Gabe. There are some comments out there that people are saying this is one of the most beautiful songs they've ever heard.
Really?
And luckily, they got to look at me as one of the most beautiful people they've ever seen.
Well, you know, the whole time I was actually thinking, I forgot that I left my chickens out.
And
I feel terrible.
Okay. Well, at least the chickens got to hear your singing.
The visual, yeah. You know, but actually, I think we might need them for the next song.
Well, let's talk about that actually.
I'll keep them out.
You've definitely had a rather diverse career with so many contemporary works. So this is traditional opera to musical theater crossover, including Music Man, Brigadoon, Fantastics, Wonderful Town, Carousel. There's so much.
Yeah. Yes. And actually, you know, it all started really in high school, as far as my love for music theater. Yeah, naturally, you know, I wasn't in High School Musical, but I was in the High School Musical. Anyways, okay.
Oh, gosh.
I tried to make a joke. That was rough. I deserve that.
Yeah, we're not all in this together.
But if you can believe it, Chef, I was actually Ren McCormick and Footloose.
Oh, wow.
In high school. I know. I don't know how I fit in those jeans. They were my
Did
brothers.
You do the dancing?
Kind of. I don't know if anyone could say what I did was dancing, but I got through the show. And I also, you know, every teenager has to play the role of Tevye.
Absolutely. That's actually one of our favorites.
Of course. Well, why don't we hear a little bit?
Let's hear it.
If I were a rich man, yabba digga 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 dee do dee do dum.
all day long I'd bitty bitty bum. If I were a wealthy man, wouldn't have to work hard. Yugga digga 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 dee do dido dum. If I were a bitty bitty rich digga digga dee do dido man, I'd build a big tall house with rooms by the dozen right in the middle of the town. A fine tin roof with real wooden floors below. I'd build a big tall staircase just going up and one even longer going down. And one more leading nowhere just for show. I'd fill my yard with chicks and turkeys and geese and ducks for the town to see and hear, squawking just as noisily as they can. And each lambikin, quack, 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 would sound like a trumpet to the ear, as if to say, here lives a wealthy man. If I were a rich man, yabba digga 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 deedle diddle dum. All day long I'd bitty bitty bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Digga 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 deedle diddle dum. Oh, if I were a bitty bitty rich digga digga deedle diddle man, I'd see my wife, my Goda, looking like a rich man's wife with a proper double chin, supervising meals to her heart's delight. I'd see her putting on airs and strutting like a peacock. Oh, what a happy mood she's in, screaming at the servants day and night. Important men in town would come to fawn on me. They would ask me to advise them, like a Solomon the wise. If you please, Reptavia, pardon me, Reptavia. Causing problems that would cross a rabbi's eye. Da 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 da. Won't make one bit of difference if I answer right or wrong. When you're rich, they think you really know. If I were rich, I'd have the time that I lack to sit at the synagogue and pray, and maybe have a seat by the Eastern Wall. And I discuss the holy books with the learned men 7 hours every day. This would be the sweetest thing of all. If I were a rich man, yabba digga 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 deedle dino dum. All day long I'd bitty bitty bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Yabba digga 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 deedle dino dum. Lord who made the lion and the lamb, you decreed I should be what I am. Would it spoil some vast eternal plan if I were a wealthy man?
So if you can believe it, I did that in 10th grade, Chev, at West Orange High School. Shout out to West Orange High School. And another song that was actually a request today, this one goes out to our friends over at the Mayflower Retirement Center. We've missed seeing you guys. Ruth McDaniel requested this one from My Fair Lady.
I've grown accustomed to her face. She almost makes the day begin. I've grown accustomed to the tune she whistles night and noon. Her smiles, her frowns, her ups, her downs are second nature to me now. Like breathing out and breathing in,
I was serenely independent and content before we met. Surely I can always be that way again, and yet I've grown accustomed to her looks, accustomed to her voice, accustomed to her face.
Take it, Robin. Since you should dance for it, Chef. I would dance, I'm dancing like Sarah Reynolds.
I've gotten used to hear say, good morning every day, her woes, her joys, her highs, her lows, are second nature to me now. By breathing out or breathing in, I'm very grateful she's a woman and so easy to forget. Rather like a habit I could always break, and yet I've grown accustomed to the trace of something in the air, accustomed to her face.
I know our friends at the Mayflower and Ruth are very excited that you sang that for them. So we do miss you, and we hope to see you all very soon.
This is not alcohol, just for the record.
Well, now, okay, well, you know. Well, before we get to our last selection of the concert, I want to thank you all so much for joining us. I wish we could...
The last selection?
Yeah, the last selection.
Oh, Chef, that's sad.
I know, I'm sorry. Oh, my God. So, even though we can't be together in person, I definitely feel still very close to you all. Well, we do appreciate you all for hopefully that you enjoyed this concert today. Show some love to Gabe, specifically in the comments. By the way, Coleman says hello.
Coleman? Oh my gosh, my nephew is watching.
Your nephew is watching.
This live stream thing really does work to get the younger kids.
Yeah. show Gabe some support and some
if they like the concert.
I love the concert, so I'll definitely be showing some support. Okay. But also not just for the concert, but also to Opera Orlando by showing some love in a donation. Any donation made today will be doubled, actually, thanks to our friend and Opera Orlando board member, Frank Daugherty, and his wife, Mary, who have put in a $50,000 challenge.
Wow. Hallelujah.
That's amazing.
Right. That is amazing.
That's right. Every dollar that you donate to Opera Orlando will be doubled. No gift is too large or too small.
Exactly right. $5 or $5,000, might as well go for it. And the truth of the matter, we are in the middle of Empower the Arts, a campaign with United Arts. They are doing a 15% match. So if you donate right now through United Arts to Opera Orlando, it's a 115% match.
115%.
Not a better time. There's no better time
to
donate. So yeah, text the word OPERA, O-P-E-R-A, to 71777 to make that donation, get that match.
And what happens if someone does a $75 donation?
Well, I'm happy you asked, Chef. I feel like we're on a game show. next week is our fifth anniversary party, virtually broadcast out there. If you donate $75, you get access to that party, so you can join us again next week.
And I will definitely be there. But virtually,
virtually,
so I'll be tuning in. Also,
Day.
Tickets for Opera Orlando's first production of Deflator Mouse or The Revenge of the Bat are on sale now to Opera Orlando Ambassadors and will be on sale to the general public next Friday.
That's right. That's
so the season packages are still available as we speak.
Exactly right. There's a lot to look forward to.
So...
Does that cover us right now for announcements? Okay, well, before we do our big finale here, so to speak, I want to give a special thanks to Timucua Arts Foundation for hosting us. What a lovely venue here. Yeah, let's hear it for them. Special thanks to Benoit Glazer, who is our sound engineer, making us get out there to you and sound good. Also, big thanks to our friend Robin Stamper on the piano, my buddy.
And a huge thanks to your page turner, the hand of Michelle Engelman over there, ladies and gentlemen. The
hand golden hand, right
the
over
golden
there.
Hand. We got Chev Lovett. Big shout out to him.
No big deal.
And you know, Chev, we forgot to thank our artist sponsors today.
Let's go ahead and thank them.
Robin Stamper is sponsored today by Larry and Nancy Wagers.
Thank
big
you,
shout
Larry
out to
and
them.
Nancy. Yeah.
And I want to give my love to Ellen Gannett, who is sponsoring me. Hey, Ellen, I hope you're watching. And as always, her donation is in honor of her late husband, my dear friend, Erwin Nebelkoff.
We miss Erwin, but we do thank you, Ellen, for supporting this.
So this last song is very apropos because I sang it right here for one of our Meet the Stars concerts. And it was the same day as the gender reveal for my daughter, Cora. At the time, I didn't know if it was going to be a boy or a girl, and all those thoughts fly through your head. So nothing better to capture that than Soliloquy from Carousel.
I wonder what'll think of me. I guess he'll call me the old man. I guess he'll think I can lick every other feller's father. Well, I can. I bet that he'll turn out to be a spitting image of his dad. But he'll have more common sense than his pudding-headed father ever had. I'll teach him to wrestle and dive through a wave when we go in the mornings for our swim. His mother can teach him the way to behave, but she won't make a sissy out of him. Not him, not my boy. Not Bill. Bill. My boy Bill, I will see that he's named after me. I will. My boy Bill, he'll be tall and as tough as a tree. Well, Bill, like a tree, he'll grow with his head held high and his feet planted firm on the ground. And you won't see nobody dare to try to boss him or toss him around. No fat bottom, flabby faced bully will boss him around. And I don't give a damn what he does, as long as he does what he likes. He could sit on his tail or work on a rail with a hammer and spikes. He could ferry a boat on a river, or pedal a pack on his back, or work up and down the streets of a town with a whip and a horse and a hack. He could haul a scow along a canal, run a cow around a corral, or maybe bark for the carousel. Of course, it takes talent to do that well. He might be the champ of the heavyweights, or a fellow who sells you glue, or president of the United States. That'd be all right too. His mother would like that. But he wouldn't be president unless he wanted to be. Not Bill. My boy Bill, he'll be tall and as tough as a tree. Well, Bill, like a tree, he'll grow with his head held high and his feet planted firm on the ground. And you won't see nobody dare to try to boss him or toss him around. No fat bottom, flabby face, pot belly, baggy eyed bastard will boss him around. And I'm damned if he marries his boss's daughter, a skinny-lipped virgin with blood like water, who give him a peck and call it a kiss and stare at his eyes through a lorgnette. Say, why am I taking on like this? My kid ain't even been born yet. I can see him when he's 17 or so and starting in to go with a girl. I could give him lots of pointers, very sound, on the way to get round any girl. I could tell him, wait a minute, could it be? What the hell? What if he is a girl? Oh, Bill.
I do with her? What could I do for a bum with no money? You can have fun with the sun, but you gotta be a father to a girl. She mightn't be so bad at that, a kid with ribbons in her hair, a kind of neat and petite little tin type of her mother. What a pair. My little girl, pink and white, as peaches and cream is she. My little girl is half again as bright as girls are meant to be. Dozens of boys pursue her, many a likely lad does what he can to woo her from her faithful dad. She has a few pink and white young fellows of 2 and 3, but my little girl gets hungry every night, and she comes home to me. My little girl, my little girl, I gotta get ready before she comes. I gotta make certain that she won't be tracked up in slums with a lot of bums like me. She's gotta be sheltered and fed and dressed in the best that money can buy. I never know how to get money, but I'll try, by God, I'll try. I'll go out and make it, or steal it, or take it, or die.
Thank you, audience of one. And speaking of encore, Sheb, you are doing a little encore yourself. Right after this will be another episode of Representation Matters. Tell us all about that.
That's right, Gabe. You know, it was an honor to actually sit down with Orange County Mayor Jerry Demings and Rafael Torres with United Arts.
Wonderful.
On this month's episode, and there are a few faces that folks might be able to see, and there's a few guest surprises. We've already seen some great and have had some great conversations via the series, and it is our hope or dream, you might say, that the arts can bring us all together and help us find a common ground of our shared humanity.
Shared humanity, I love that. And that's another great segue for a little encore. How about Impossible Dream?
Oh, please.
To dream the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe, to run when your legs are too weary, to go where the brave dare not go, to right the unrightable wrong, to love pure and chase from afar, to try when your arms are too weary, to reach the unreachable star. This is my quest, to follow that star, no matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right without question or cause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know, if I'll only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest. And the world will be better for this.
that one man, scorned and covered in scars, still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable stars. This is my quest, to follow that star, no matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right, without question or pause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know, if I'll only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest. One man, scorned and covered in scars, still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable.